In today's Your Healthy Family, we're taking you in the operating room with orthopedic surgeon Dr. Chris Jones to give Greg Arnold a brand new shoulder. And we do want to give you a heads up, this is video of a surgery as it happens.
They just deteriorated on me fast. By the time I was probably 40, the first doctor that took a look at him said I had the arthritis of a 70-year-old man.
When Dr. Jones evaluated Greg Arnold's severely arthritic shoulders, he saw an opportunity to use a new navigation application for total shoulder replacement called Exactech GPS, or guided personalized surgery. It's a pioneering tool in total shoulder replacement.
It kind of just takes it to the next level. So it actually takes your plan and just helps you perfect it.
Greg's left shoulder went so well, and the results were so good, the decision was easy for him to move forward with the right shoulder. Dr. Jones showed me how the technology helps great surgeons perform nearly perfect procedures on a model in his office.
It all starts with some advanced imaging. So you get a CAT scan, and a CAT scan can give us an image that looks like this. You can basically create a model of the shoulder from those images. And we're using the images on the CAT scan to help guide through the surgery so that we can actually put the prosthesis or the replacement part in exactly like we plan to do it on the computer before surgery.
The software allows the surgeon to spend the time studying the specific bone structure of the patient and virtually plan out the implants he will use on a computer and see exactly how he wants each one of them to fit on what's left of the existing bone, and the exact angles and depth of each hole and screw that needs to be put in place, and how the glenoid, the curved face of the scapula, needs to be shaved and prepared, essentially erasing any guesswork a surgeon would have to rely on, allowing them to perfectly execute their surgical plan.
But again, this is the challenge, is making sure you get everything within this little piece of bone. And it's not hard when it's normal anatomy, but when you have the wear and the erosion because of somebody has just really advanced arthritis, it just makes things a lot easier.
Dr. Jones invited me into the operating room to see Mr. Arnold's right shoulder total replacement. Here's how the Exactech GPS works. After the patient is under and the shoulder joint is opened up, a fixed sensor is attached to the scapula. There's also a sensor on the surgeon's tools that move with the instruments. The stationary sensor and the sensor on the instruments are both picked up by sensors mounted on the monitor. With all the sensors communicating, the program then asks the surgeon to map specific points on the bone. When the sensor's readings match the patient's existing scan in the computer, the colors are green. With the sensors now in sync with the 3D scan in the computer and the patient's anatomy in space, the monitor shows in real time each move the surgeon will make.
And this is usually the most important screw because of the strength of this screw. And so you can see, I mean, just angling, you want to make sure you try to get in bone and you're trying to get right down the pipe.
Ensuring the pre-planned exact angles, depths, and hardware are all placed exactly where the surgeon wants them and showing them as they happen in real time.
We've used CT scans for a long time for this. We'd have in our mind, you know, the three-dimensional picture of everything and reproduce it just using our surgical technique. And that can be very challenging, even for experienced surgeons.
Greg had his right shoulder replaced in mid-August and says he was out of a sling again within a few days of surgery and is healing nicely.
And for Your Healthy Family, I'm Ira Cronin. For more health stories, head to yourhealthyfamily.com.